Welcome back everybody. In my last video, I used 40 minutes to create a simple app, and in this video, I am going to create the same app, only a lot quicker. So let me just turn on my desktop here, close OBS. Well, the app that we're going to make is this. It's gonna have a frame and a title, welcome to my first app. It's gonna have a label, it's gonna have some styling, and then this label underneath this will be more text, and then we'll have a button. And you can click on this button and then you will get a notification. And on we're gonna make this multi-platform, so for iOS, Android, and UWP. Let's get into it. Let's start a new app. Starting Visual Studio 2019, running as administrator. Yes. Gonna make a new app. Here we're gonna say it's gonna be a mobile app. We're going to call this first quick app. I like to put the location in my dev. Place a solution and a project in the same directory. Create. I'm going to use a blank tablet. I'm going to use a blank template. Excuse me. Android, iOS, and UWP. Create. It's going to have one shared project with all the shared code in it. And it's going to have three other projects. One iOS, one Android, and one UWP. And I'm using UWP to quickly check the app because it builds the fastest on UWP. So if I now build the app, we'll just get one main page because the preset is one blank page. And it will already have some information in it for us. So it's building right now. And then in any minute, we should see the screen. Let's make it small so we can see what it looks like on devices that have the screen size. It looks like this. So we already got some. It wants to connect to my Mac, but my Mac is offline, so let's not do that. So this is what it looks like when we build it. What we want is this frame to be more rounded. We want to change this text. We want to change this text. We want to change this text. And we want to get rid of this link and just put a button here that will make an alert for us. So let's go. We can keep it here. So while I make the changes, we can see how the changes in the code affect the UI. So let's just say we'll do it like this, and then this building to the side. So when I open the shared folder with the shared code, I have my main page. So that's the page that we're seeing here on the right side. It's called from our app SAML.cs. When the app starts, it initializes some components. Let me just make this a little bit bigger. It initializes some components and then it shows the main page. So when we go into our main page, we have a backend and we have a front end. Then we open the front end. And then we'll see the stack layout. It has a frame and it has this color and it has a corner radius of 0. We want this corner radius to be 25. Now we'll see that it has a corner radius here, but we also want it to have a margin, so it does pull a bit off the sides of the screen. Let's make that 20. That's better. Then we want to say, welcome to my first quick app. Multi-platform. Just lost my mouse over there. And then we're going to say the label underneath it says start developing. We're going to say I've started developing. And then we're going to say here, this is my first app. How do you like it? Please press the button. Right. So then we'll have our label here. Let me just give it a background color so you can see it. This label we want to replace with a button. So we're going just to delete this. Then we'll say opening tag. Button, then we give it a text like click me. We'll have a corner radius of I don't know, 20 also, and a margin of maybe 50, and a background color of, I don't know, let's just say blue. And then we'll have the closing tag, so slash closing tag, and that's where we'll see our button. Maybe we'll change the text color to white, and now we'll have a beautiful button that still does nothing. So let's give it a clicked event. So when we say clicked, you see the thunderbolt, it's an event. We can press tab here, then it suggests to make a new event handler in the code behind. We'll press enter. The code behind can be entered by selecting putting the cursor in here and pressing F12. Now we're going to the code behind, and there we'll have a button clicked event. You can also reach this place if you go to your solution explorer, and your main page XAML is now open. You can go to the code behind by double clicking this. There's also a way to get there, but I like to on the front end just press F12 and then go straight into the code. And then here this is the code that runs when people press the click me button. And I'm just gonna say, because this content page, I can say this display alert, and then the display alert has some arguments, title, message, and cancel. They're all strings, so let's just put a string here, like var title is var message is, I was just reading my comment, was reading the notification, so I made some errors there. And then the cancel button text is, let's say, okay. Oh no, it was gonna be title, have you subscribed yet? Well, did you?
Ik ben nou weer hier.
Ja.
Dan.
Ik ben aan het opnemen en aan het testen. Sorry about that. I just got some fruit from the garden from my lovely girlfriend, soon to be wife. And the cancel button will have it be no, but I sure will. All right, so then we're just gonna put those in here. We'll say we'll have the title, we'll have the message, we'll have the cancel button text. And then right now it doesn't work yet, because if you change the code behind, you have to rebuild the application. So let's rebuild the application. And now it will look like this. It also does the scaling correctly. So for bigger screens. Now when we click the click me, you'll get this alert. Have you subscribed yet? Well, did you? No, but I sure will. And when we press it, we cancel the alert. Right, and now if we want to build this for Android, for example, we can say set a starter project, then build it on a Pixel A3 XL. We'll need to have a lot of patience. So this is why I'm building on UWP. To check for bugs or anything else, because UWP is so much faster than building on, let's say, Android simulator or iOS simulator, or devices for that matter. Ah, here we go. And there we go. We have our first app running on the Android simulator. So this is what it's going to look like. I'm going to click it. Have you subscribed yet? That's a hard word. Well, did you? No, but I sure will. And if we click it, it goes away, and it's all in the Android native library written. So that's why this looks different than in the UWP. Now, if you want to send this to somebody because you're proud of your first application, you can say, I want to put this in release mode. And then we'll just go to the properties of the Android project. And we'll just have to check the Android options here to make sure that this says we're building an APK, not a bundle. The bundle is for uploading to the Play Store, so it must be APK. And then we'll right click here and we're going to archive this. Now the archiving process will make sure that all this good code that you just written in C# will be compiled into an APK. And this APK can be put on any device, any Android device, and then be installed. So if I put this this USB-C cable on the Windows laptop, I can put my tablet or my phone on it, and then I trust it. Then I put this APK that I'm building right now, I can put it in the downloads folder. Then I open on my tablet or phone the downloads folder. I will install the APK. I will trust the developer, because that's the thing you have to do. And then I can see this app on my phone whenever I want. This is how you make sure that you can test it on a real device in release mode. Because there's a difference between debugging and releasing. When you're releasing, they also the code also gets compacter, and there's some linking and some stuff can go wrong. So it's always good to check your release version also after you're done with your debug version. So now we have our APK. We can say we want to distribute this. We do not want to put it in Google Play. We want to do this ad hoc. Then we can just create ourselves say identity to sign it with. An identity makes sure that an application is signed by the developer, so it's just like a double check to make sure there's no malicious code in it. So if I choose this one that I made earlier, or I can make a new one, let's say I make a new one, I say this is a tutorial, I can have a password, I have to confirm it, how many years you want it to be valid. You can, of course, just name this anything you want. It's just so they can make this private key out of it to sign your apps with. Now you guys know where I live. Create. So now I've made a new key and I'm going to sign this application with it. And I'm going to export to my desktop and I'm going to name this First Quick App. Now it will ask me for the password I just entered. It has signed it, and when I go out here, I see that I have my APK. So now when my Android device is not here. I'm getting my Android device. One moment. And I'm back. Those were a lot of stairs. All right, so this is my Android tablet. I'm just going to connect it to my PC. Then I'm just going to copy this APK, go to my Galaxy tab, open up the drive, go to my downloads, put it in here. Okay, all right. So now I go to my download folder, it's on the left downside. Go to my downloads. Then I'll have my First Quick App APK. I press it. Then I install it. I'm going to have to trust the developer. Then I can open it. And right now we see the application running on a real device. I can even switch the orientation. And when I press the Click Me button, I get the notification. Have you subscribed yet? Well, did you? No, but I sure will. All right, guys, that's all there is to it. I hope this quick format was a nice format for you guys. If it wasn't, or I can do anything better, or you'd like to see more of this kind of quick app development, please let me know in the comments. I will read them and we'll get back to you as soon as possible. Bye, guys.